Thank you. I don't know if I can get this all in a minute. For those of you who don't know me, I was a judge, Supreme Court judge, for 19 years. I worked with the Assembly for about the same number of years. And I worked for Legal Aid Society before that. Before that, I've got to say, Cy Vance has been an obstructionist and worked with the Republican Senate to stop almost every criminal justice reform that you care about. In the recent Raise the Age, he was the one who said, don't send cases right to family court and limit the number of cases that go there. On wrongful convictions, he's the one who says, only use custodial, taping of custodial interrogations in limited number of cases and don't have consequences if the police don't follow the rules. And on what they call the Brady Rule, and that is an obligation of a DA to turn over exculpatory evidence, and most wrongful convictions are a result of hidden evidence that's discovered later. He's the one who, I'm on the OCA, the opposite. I'll come back, I'll speak forever on this.
All right,
Hi, my name is Tiochino. I passed this paper earlier. I'm asking the club to vote a no endorsement on the DA of Cyrus Vance. The reason for that is simply because he wants our phone to be, he wants to create a back door. Last time at the VID club, he said that what he wants is to have a warrant for Apple to open the door. That is like asking permission. The problem is, criminal, don't ask permission to steal your stuff from your phone. You lose your phone in the street, criminal will use the same tool that Apple has, the FBI has, to go through your phone and rampage your phone. So his excuse of asking permission puts every activist throughout the whole world in danger, because maybe New York's judges will issue warrants, but people around the world, autocrats, will not ask permission to go over their activist phone. So what happened here happened all over the world. Please vote no. Thank you.
Well said.
Tom.
I mean, last time when Cy Vance was running, he came to a lot of meetings and he was going to be very progressive. He said he was going to set up certain different courts for minor offenses, this and that. He had a good talk, but very little good came out of him. And I think he's a dangerous man. And I think he comes from a dangerous background. He's a very privileged person from the highest levels of society in New York City. His father was a big official, Cy Vance, the first one. He's the next one. I think he's been terrible. He's bad for poor people. He's bad for young people. He's bad for old people. In other words, he's bad.
Tony.
One of the things I feel very strongly about is wrongful convictions and clemencies, but especially wrongful convictions. And that's one of the reasons why I oppose the death penalty, is the wrongful conviction aspect of it. In Brooklyn, they set up a small unit, but a unit to deal with wrongful convictions, to go back and look at the convictions, use DNA and more modern techniques, and try to see if to exculpate those people who were wrongly convicted. Cy Vance really doesn't do it to nearly the extent that they do it in Brooklyn. And Manhattan should be the most liberal borough. It should be the most progressive, the furthest advanced. And we have what's basically a conservative district attorney. And so I think we should send a message by voting no.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
David.
I'm just going to take the unpopular side of this. I mean, everything that's said, I think, is really valid, and I actually agree on the substantive positions that pretty much everyone's taken in terms of the bills that Cy's pushed. I often don't support in terms of privacy, in terms of some other things. I just think that Cy's a very good district attorney. In terms of exculpatory things, one of the main reasons he doesn't do quite the extent of Brooklyn is that Brooklyn has a really, really bad, shady history and a really big backlog of really problematic convictions that aren't as bad.
What?
I think Cy's shown, I mean, if you compare the two, I'm not saying there are no problems in Manhattan. I think Cy's shown very good judgment in his prosecution, and I think that's something that doesn't come out in the papers, because if it comes out in the papers, that's when you've shown bad judgment. So while substantively I agree that a lot of the things he's pushing aren't that good, the question is, what do you want in a prosecutor? I think you want a good judgment, and you think you want someone who runs a competent office as a prosecutor. And so that's why I endorse him, all the other good points brought against him.
Thank you.
Okay. Sorry.
Okay.
The reason I came here tonight is to specifically talk about Silas Vance Jr. and what he did to me as a fourth generation New Yorker. He sent me to Rikers because my batterer up in Harlem was his confidential informant that helped him sweep through Harlem and make all those RICO gang conspiracies that put 14, 15, and 16 years in jail for 20 years for selling dime bags. Silas Vance does not want to be district attorney for his whole life. His daddy was Secretary of State. He wants to fulfill his daddy's shoes and fulfill the political efficacy of his father that his father had to forsake when he threw his body across the tracks of the Iran hostage situation. Why I went to Rikers Island, he tried to charge me with 324 counts of CPLR 240.30, which was a statute that said that any electronic communication that annoys or alarms the recipient is a criminal act. Think about the broad police stroke to First Amendment impediment that was. Cy Vance used that statute to go after his political enemies. He went after poor Raphael Gold, who, if you remember, was a study scholar at Harvard. He went after all kinds of people to try and impinge their free speech. I brought a handout because I'd really like you to know some of the evil that Cy Vance has been up to. He's the first one to bring Palantir digital technologies into New York City that allow law enforcement to go through every aspect of your digital life. I'm going to shut up, but if you'll please look at all of the different onerous things that Cy Vance has done, as far as his judgment, putting a domestic violence survivor on Rikers Island and charging her with 324 counts of an unconstitutional statute so that he can make big gang busts in Harlem using a proper provider, is against the
Grace, thank you. 3 more minutes, if anyone likes to.
I could go on and on about political positions that he's taken, but I'm not gonna do that. Instead, I'm gonna respond to two of the points that were raised. Okay, his management style. I ran what was called a tier two part, and that meant that I had hundreds of cases that would come in front of me. He is not personally involved. As Tony said, he's distant. He has six people who run their units below him, and they do whatever the heck he wants. And there's no unified policy. And as a judge, you're completely frustrated by the fact that there's one rule over depend on what DA happened to indict you. That's what happens. And with regard to what Tony talked about, the exculpatory units and everything, I handled a bunch of 440 units, which is the post-conviction relief habeas cases. And his unit comes in to defend the prior action. They pretend that they're doing a second look at whether or not there was a rightful conviction, but more often than not, they're covering their ass.
Thank you.
I will talk about something else I discovered about the DA. I read the Constitution of the State of New York. The DA's job is to prosecute people who are supposedly criminal. What I discovered that the DA did throughout this whole thing about encryption, about other things, was that the DA was trying to take the job of the mayor, to say, what rule will take crime away from the city? That's not the job of the DA. That's the job of the elected official, of city council, of the mayor, to say, what policy do we want for our city to be for New York City? And suddenly, by doing all these cyber crimes, cyber cities, or what other group he's working on, he's suddenly taking the job of deciding, how can we prevent crime? And that's not his job. That's the job of the NYPD. That's the job of the mayor. That's the job of city council. That's not for him to decide, what do we want for our city as far as crime fighting. He is supposed to fight the crime when he gets to court. Thank you very much.
Well,